Hello guys. Today I want to show you an example using LINQ queries to compare two data tables. I got the question from a subscriber, and I think it could be interesting for you also. The question is how to compare two data tables or Excel files, and get only the new rows, which appears in one of the both files. Let's see the following example to understand the use case better. Assume I have the following two tables. The old table contains the old data, which we had before. Let's say it contains the basic data. The new table contains the new data, which consists of both old data and new data. Or it could contains only new data, which we don't have in the old table. The question is how to get only the new rows from the new table, which are only in the new table, but not in the old table. It means, we want to get only the new data, which we don't have in the basic data. The compare should be using the column employee ID. It means, this column is a primary key column, where the values appear only once. In our example here we should get only these three rows, which are only in the new table. Let's say we want to store them in a new table, out table. I hope the use case is clear for you now, what I want to do in this video. I will switch to UiPath to start writing the LINQ query. I have here these three variables. Old table. New table. Out table. All three variables are of type data table. I have here build data table activity, where I define the old table. Let's see the table. It consists of three columns. We have here different rows. The table is exact the same, what I showed you at the beginning. And here I have another build data table activity, where I define the new table. It consists also of three columns. Here we also have different rows. Some of these rows are in the old table, but some rows are new. As mentioned, I want to store the new rows in a new variable, out table. The first thing we have to do is to set the columns for the out table. It means we have to clone the tables. I can use any table from both, either old table or new table. After executing this activity, we will have the same columns in out table as what we have in new table. It means out table contains now three columns, but no rows. Now I will write the query. I will explain it later. So first we have a loop for the rows of the new table. After that I defined a variable with the name exists. Using this variable I want to check if the row from the new table exists in the old table. For that I used any operator. I already published a video about this operator, what does it mean and how to use it. Please watch the video if you want to learn more about this operator. You can find the link in the video description. Any is used to check if the data source contains any element. So here we check if the old table contains the row from the new table. For that I use the column employee ID, because this column is a primary key, as mentioned at the beginning. But if you have more than one column as primary key, you can use all columns to set the condition. So the result of this operator is true or false. True if we have the row in the old table. And false if we don't have the row in the old table. The last statement is select, to select the row we want as output. Here I used if condition. If exists means, if we found the row in the old table. In this case I don't want to select anything. But we have to do something here, therefore I use this expression to add an empty row to the old table. But if the row doesn't exist in the old table, I want to select it. It means, this row is a new one, which we don't have in the old table. At the end I convert the output to data table type. I will add output data table to convert the table to string, so that I can show you how does the out table look like. I will store the table in this variable. It's of type string. And now I will add write line activity to print out the result. Let's execute it to check, what will we get as output? We have the following table as output. Here we have the columns. And below the rows. As you see, we have these three rows, which we don't have in the old table. So it works fine. But we also have here some empty rows, which we don't need in the output table. Let's edit the query to remove these empty rows. As you know, we get a data table as output from the query. We want to loop this table again and check if the column employee ID is null or empty. So we select each row where this column is not null or empty. It means we remove the empty rows. At the end, I converted the output again to data table. Let's execute it again to check the new result. As you see, we have now only the new rows, and there are no empty rows anymore. This is how to compare two tables to get only the new rows. As you see, we get the new rows using this query. But if we don't have any new rows in the new table, what should we get as result? Let's remove the new rows from this table, so that we don't have any new rows. Only the same rows as what we have in the old table. This is the old table, which contains the same rows. Let's now execute it again and check what happens. As you see, we got the following exception, because we don't have any rows, which meet the condition. The source contains no data rows. The exception appears because of this part of query, because we try to convert rows to data table, but we don't have any rows. So I will delete this part, where I remove the empty rows. I will execute the code again to show you that we don't get an exception. As you see, we don't have any exceptions. We have here the columns, and below only empty rows. We have 6 empty rows, because the new table contains 6 rows. So we need to remove the empty rows again, but not in the link query. I will do that using filter data table activity. We need to filter the out table, therefore I will add it as input and output. Let's configure the filter. This condition means that I want to remove all rows where the employee ID column is empty. Let's execute the code again and check the result. As you see, we only have the columns here but no rows. It means we don't have any new rows in the new table, but also no exceptions or empty rows. In this way, we can compare two data tables and get the different rows from one table based on another table. I hope you enjoyed the video and could use this query in your process, once you have something similar. Thanks for watching and have a great day.